हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ एसआरएन इंटरनेशनल स्कूल जयपुर। आई एम माया शर्मा, फैकल्टी ऑफ साइंस एट एसआरएन इंटरनेशनल स्कूल जयपुर। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट एयर एंड इट्स यूजेस। चिल्ड्रन, यू ऑलरेडी नो ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स रिक्वायर एयर, बट हैव यू एवर सीन एयर? यू माइट नॉट हैव सीन एयर, बट श्योरली you must have felt its presence in so many ways. You notice it when the leaves of the tree rustle, or the clothes hanging on a clothesline sway, pages of an open book begin fluttering, when the fan is switched on. The moving air makes it possible for you to fly your kite. So we can say air is present all around us. Air is invisible, tasteless, and no smell. It is needed to sustain our lives. We can live without food and water for days, but we cannot live without air for more than a few minutes. Children, our earth is surrounded by a blanket of air called the atmosphere. The atmosphere extends up to a height of about 300 km above the Earth's surface. We go higher in the atmosphere, the amount of air becomes lesser. That's why mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders with them. Children, atmosphere is very important. It maintains the temperature of the earth for the survival of living things. It burns the meteorites before they reach the earth's surface. It protects us from harmful UV rays of the sun. Now question arises, what is air? Air is a mixture of many gases, about 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, 1% other gases like neon, argon, carbon dioxide, and ozone are present in the air. It also contains water vapor and dust particles. Children, all gases are very useful. Now let's take one by one. Nitrogen. It occupies nearly 4/5 of the space that is filled by air. Nitrogen is an important constituent of all fertilizers. It is essential for growth of plants. Oxygen. 1/5 of air is made up of oxygen. Life would not be possible without oxygen. We need oxygen for respiration. During respiration, we breathe in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. Another very important function of oxygen is it supports burning. Carbon dioxide. Air contains a tiny amount of carbon dioxide, but its presence is very important. Carbon dioxide is required by plants to carry out the process of photosynthesis. This process results in the production of food and the release of oxygen. Carbon dioxide is also responsible for trapping the sun's heat. Carbon dioxide is also used in fire extinguisher. Water vapor. The presence of water vapor in air is important for the water cycle in nature. Dust and smoke. The amount of dust particle and smoke in air varies from place to place. It helps in formation of clouds. Children, you know how gases are balanced in the atmosphere? During photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is used and oxygen is released. During the respiration, this oxygen is used and carbon dioxide is released. During burning, oxygen is used up and carbon dioxide is released. The total amount of oxygen and carbon dioxide remain balanced in the air through this process. Children, you know, air is not only required for respiration and photosynthesis, but also used in a number of ways for various applications. Air helps in dispersal of seeds and thereby in the multiplication and survival of plants. Wind helps the windmills to rotate, which can be used to generate electricity and run flour mills. Air plays an important role in the water cycle. Air plays an important role in the pollination of flowers. Here, wind is the dispersal of agent. Compressed air is used for inflating vehicles' tires. Oxygen, a constituent of air, is essential for burning of fuels. Air is essential for the movement of sailboats. Packets of chips are flushed with nitrogen to prevent their spoilage. So we can say air is very important for us. So dear student, that was all about today's topic. I hope you must have understood about air and its uses. Thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel to get more knowledgeable videos. Thank you.